I'm completely offline at the moment. So let's go back to Langflow and let's see if my Mr. Beast clone still works. In the playground, let's enter something like, "Who are you?" And even though we're offline, our AI model is still working. And let's also ask a question from our knowledge base just to test the RAG functionality. How much money were you offered for a video when you were 19? And the chatbot was able to answer this question from a knowledge base, which I created by grab the URL of this video where Mr. Beast was giving YouTube advice for 10 minutes straight. I then used this website to download the transcript, and I then pasted that transcript into a simple text file, which I saved on my local machine. This is a super efficient technique for creating AI copies of real-world people, but if you simply wanted an AI solution for chatting with PDF documents, then this tutorial will be perfect for you as well. There are plenty of reasons as to why you would want to run models locally. First, your data is private and will not be sent to companies like OpenAI. It's also entirely free since it uses open-source models, and you can also download uncensored models for creating some interesting role-playing chatbots. As for the prerequisites, we need to install Langflow and Ollama. I already have dedicated videos on both setting up Langflow and setting up Ollama. So if you do want a deep dive into each of these platforms and check out these videos over here, let's start by installing Langflow. Create a new folder on your machine, and then within this folder, open your terminal or command prompt. Let's first create a virtual environment by entering python-m venv followed by venv. Let's then activate the virtual environment by typing venv scripts and activate. And if the environment was successfully activated, you should see this env prefix at the start of the command. Let's now install Langflow by running pip install Langflow. After installation is complete, we can run Langflow by typing Langflow and run. We can then copy this URL to open Langflow in the browser. If you see this dashboard, then Langflow was installed successfully. Now, before we create our chatbot, let's also install Ollama. Ollama allows us to run LLM models on our local machines. It also makes it super easy to download open source models. We can install Ollama by going to ollama.com and then click on download. Simply select your operating system and click on download. Now simply execute the file and follow the setup process. We can check that Ollama is working by opening the command prompt and then entering Ollama. And you should see all of these options pulling through. Now let's download two models. You can find all the available models on the Ollama website by clicking on models and then browsing these available models. For this demo, we will be using Llama 3 as our primary model for chatting with the chatbot, and we will download a separate model as the embeddings model. We can download a model by typing Ollama pool and then the model name, like Llama 3. Now let's download one more model by typing Ollama pool. At this time, we want to download an embedding model. So back in Ollama, I'll just enter embed and let's download this gnomic embed text model. So I'll simply copy this and then paste it into the terminal and press enter. Great, that is all we need to get the solution working. Of course, you can also use the Ollama website to download all sorts of uncensored models. So now that we have Ollama and Langflow set up, let's go ahead and create our Mr. Beast clone. Let's start by creating a new project and let's select the blank flow. Let's start by giving our project a name. On the top left, click on this drop-down and click on settings. Let's give it a name like Mr. Beast Clone and let's save this. Let's start by adding an input node onto the canvas and specifically the chat input node. And then let's also add an output node and more specifically the chat output node, like so. This simply allows us to chat with the application and receive some sort of chat output. So in theory, what we could do is connect the input to the output node and then run this in the playground. And whatever we enter here will simply be echoed back to us, like so. Now, obviously that's not what we want, and also I don't want the response showing as AI. Let's fix that first. So on the chat output node, let's click on settings, and let's change the name of the sender to Mr. Beast. Great. Now, let's also break the connection between the input and the output node, and let's add our AI model into the mix. So under the nodes, let's go to models, and from here, let's add Ollama as our node. From the Ollama node, we can specify the base URL, and this is the default URL that is used by Ollama, but if for some reason you are using a different port, then be sure to use that port instead. Also, when we click on model name, we can see all the models that we installed. For you, it will only be Llama 3 and the Gnomic embed text model. Let's set this to be Llama 3. Let's also change the temperature to a higher value like 0.6, just to make the model slightly more creative. Then for the input, I'll simply pass in the chat input. And let's pass the output of the model into the chat output node. Let's give this a spin. In the playground, let's say hello, and we are receiving a response back from the AI model. And this is coming from Ollama. And also note that our avatar is now called Mr. Beast. Great. Now at the moment, our model isn't really sounding like Mr. Beast. Also, if I had to ask it, what is your name? It simply tells us that it doesn't have a name. So let's fix the personality of our chatbot. For this, we will use something called a prompt template. Prompt templates can be extremely useful for passing all sorts of information to our model, like the personality, some context, the chat history, etc. So in the menu, let's go to prompts and let's add this prompt node. Then let's pass the output of the prompt node into the input of the model. Now we can use this prompt node to really prime this model. So let's open up this input box and let's start by saying something like, "You are Jimmy, also known as Mr. Beast. You are a successful content creator on YouTube. Respond to the user's question as if you are Mr. Beast." And now all we have to do is add a placeholder for the user's question. So I'll simply start by typing question followed by a variable called question. Now when we check and save this, we can now see this question input on this prompt node. So now we can take the chat input and simply pass that value into the question field of our prompt template. Great. Now watch what happens when we run this in the playground. Let's clear the chat and now let's ask, "What is your name?" And now this is starting to sound like Mr. Beast. But of course, our model does not have up-to-date information about Mr. Beast. Now, you can create the knowledge base in many different ways. As I showed at the start of the video, I simply downloaded the transcript of a YouTube video and then stored that transcript in a text file on my machine. Now the question is, how do we feed that knowledge from that file into our LLM application? To get this to work, we will implement RAG. RAG is simply the process of loading content into a database called a vector store, which will then allow our AI application to retrieve information from that database based on the user's question. First, let's create that database by going to vector stores and let's add the ChromaDB vector store. On this note, let's change the collection name to Mr. Beast, and let's also specify a folder for storing this database. Otherwise, if we had to restart this application, all of our knowledge will get lost. So open up your Langflow folder and create a new folder called Chroma. Then copy the URL to this folder and paste it into this field. Our database will now be created in this folder. Now that we have our database, we need to load the content from that text file. And this could also be a PDF file, a Word document, etc. To do that, let's add something from the data folder and let's add file. So what we could do now is simply pass the contents of the file directly into the database. The problem with this though is that the file is massive and we don't want to retrieve all of the contents every time we run a query. Instead, we're going to chunk this data into smaller bits and then create smaller records in the database. So let's actually add something called a splitter, and more specifically this recursive character text splitter, to the canvas. So let's pass the contents of our file into the text splitter. I will leave the chunk size as 1000 with a chunk overlap of 200. Now we can take these smaller documents and pass those into our database. Lastly, our database requires an embedding function. The embedding function is responsible for converting the text from our file into a numeric representation, which can be used by the database to retrieve the most relevant documents. Luckily, this is very simple. Under Notes, go to Embeddings, and under Embeddings, add the Ollama Embeddings node. Then, let's attach the Embeddings node to the Embeddings input on our vector store. Let's also change the model from Llama 2 to the Gnomic embed text model, which we downloaded earlier. Now, this is actually all we need to feed the data into the database. So I'll start by selecting that text file with the transcript, and we can now upsert this data into the database by simply executing the ChromaDB node. And these documents are now being loaded into our database. And this took about a minute to complete, but our data was now loaded into the database. Now we just need to make this data available to our chatbot as well. So first I'm going to move all of these nodes out of the way, just to make a bit of space. And I just did that selection by holding in Shift and then dragging this selection. Let's move the upsert logic out of the way and let's continue working on our chat. The first thing we need to do is to add our vector store in this flow as well. So let's add the ChromaDB database. And we also need to ensure that this database contains the same values as the database down here. So I'll simply copy the collection name, like so. Let's also copy the directory, like so. And then the difference between this instance of the database compared to the one down here is that this instance is responsible for retrieving documents from the vector store. So the flow down here was responsible for uploading data into the vector store, whereas this instance will accept some input from the user, which we can pass in right now into the search query. And this vector store will now look for any documents closely related to the question that the user is asking, and then retrieve those results. Those results then need to be injected into our prompt. But at the moment, we don't have any input available on the prompt. We only have this question input. So let's create another variable called context, which will be responsible for storing the results from the vector store. I'll add that at the top of the prompt, and let's call this context. Let's also instruct our model to answer the questions from the context. So let's say, use the provided context for answering the question. If the answer does not exist in the context, then respond with, I don't know. Right, let's save this. Now we have this context input available, but you will also notice that if we try to pass the results into the context, it just won't work. And that is because the database response is in a different format that is expected by this context input. We first need to convert the results into text. That is simple to do as well. So under helpers, let's add the parse data node. Let's then pass the search results into this parse data node, and then let's grab the resulting text and pass that into the context of our prompt. So this now means that when we ask a question, the database will try and retrieve the most relevant documents related to the question. Those documents will then be parsed into text and then injected into our prompt. Let's go ahead and test this out. So let's ask a question about something in the knowledge base, like maybe this part here, which says that he was offered $5,000 for a video when he was 19 years old. So in the chat, let's ask, how much money were you offered for a video when you were 19 years old? And I'm receiving an error because I forgot to add an embeddings function. So either you can add another Ollama embeddings node to the canvas, or you can simply reuse the same embedding function that we added down here. I'm actually going to do that. So let's grab the output of this embedding function and let's add it to this ChromaDB node. Now let's ask this question again in the chat. So let's clear this. Let's send this question again. And look at that, we got the correct answer back. If you enjoyed this video, then please consider subscribing to my channel and hit the like button. If you would like to learn more about Langflow, then check out this dedicated series over here.